Hi everyone, it's Tony Brown here from Youth Work Toolbox, and I just wanted to do a quick video blog for you. I'm just here in the Youth Work Toolbox HQ, which is actually my loft in my house. But this is how we rock it, and you know, this is what we've got to do to make things happen. First of all, I just want to make a quick announcement for those of you that have been following me on Facebook. I haven't actually put anything out on Twitter yet, and I haven't sent anything to my email list, so I do apologise. But I actually made a huge announcement on Facebook on Monday. I had a huge response, and thank you to everyone who responded. I really appreciate your comments, your likes, and you know, your kind words. It means a lot. But yeah, like I said, I made a huge announcement, and that announcement was that on the 31st of December, I will be leaving my job and doing this Youth Work Toolbox thing full time. That's right, I'm taking the plunge. For the past 2 years, almost 2 years, since January 2012, I started Youth Work Toolbox, and I've been trying to do it while also working full time for a local authority, having a daily 2 hour commute to work, you know, family responsibilities. I've got a wife and 4 children, so you can imagine trying to do all that and still build a brand, build a blog, and you know, serve you guys out there. It's been tough, it's been really tough. But it's created a lot of opportunities and opened a lot of doors for me. So, you know, it's, as I've spoke about a number of times on the blog and on the podcast, it's tough times right now. And obviously you guys know it. You know, if you're in a youth sector, you know it's a real challenging time. And those challenges have basically reached very close to home. My substantive post at work has slightly been affected. But you know what, when we went for our first round of restructure, I said to myself, the next time this happens, I'm putting in an expression of interest for redundancy. And about, when was it, September, the email came from the chief exec, and you know, I had to be true to my word, and I followed it through, and I put in an expression of interest, and it was accepted. So, you know, I made a decision. I discussed it with my wife, I discussed it with my parents, discussed it with a few colleagues, and I thought, you know what, I need to just do this. It's an opportunity, I need to just do it. So, like I said, on the 31st of December, that'll be my last working day in my job. I'll have no more regular salary coming in, no more kind of security, you know, even though it's only as secure as you know, today notice. And I will be, for the first time in my adult life, solely responsible for providing and generating an income to provide for my household. So it's a scary time, but for those of you that know me, I'm a man of faith, and you know, I really believe that God has made a way, and that he'll keep us and provide for us. So that's my big announcement, 31st of December. That's my new year, and it's the start of the new chapter of my life. So what I plan to do is to, you know, keep you updated via maybe a video blog, a post. If you check out, I'm gonna refresh my Facebook fan page, so I'll probably keep people updated on there. But yeah, it's on. I'm taking a plunge, and I really need your support. I need your help. I need your encouragement. Like I said, to the Facebook community, sometimes just a comment, a share, a like, it makes a big difference. For those of you that are in business yourself or self-employed, you know how important networking is. You know how important just a word of encouragement is. It's tough. So yeah, I need your help, guys. So if you see me post something and I'm asking for you to like it, just like it. If I'm asking for you to share it, just click the share button. It's not going to cost you anything. So yeah, I'm not begging. I'm just saying, What I don't want to do is have to get this out. That's what I don't want to do. You know, things ain't going to get this bad. Again, like I said, I'm a man of faith, but, you know, I've got to keep it in your back pocket just in case. Anyway, what I wanted to talk about today, I was having a discussion yesterday with a colleague of mine from a substance misuse service, and we were looking at the number of referrals that came through over the last 12 months. And, you know, this service, obviously they provide advice, guidance. They basically provide a service to young people and adults who have substance misuse issues, or, you know, if they're concerned about substance misuse. Anyway, so we're looking at the referrals, or the number of referrals, and what we noticed, so it became very clear, is that we had very, very few referrals from youth workers. And we began to, you know, look at where the referrals were coming from. And I was like, well, how come we've had none from the youth workers? And we began to sort of discuss this. And I thought back to when I was doing the Youth Inclusion Programme, which was a project for young people who are at risk of offending or who were at risk of offending. And again, they would be referred into the service. And again, I ran that project for 3 years. And when I think back, I don't think we had, I can count on my hand, the number of referrals we had come through from youth workers. And then I thought back to the Targeted Youth Support Service that runs. And again, speaking with the coordinator of that programme, very, very few referrals came through from youth workers. And, you know, again, discussing and thinking about it, I was like, what's the barrier? What's the issue? You know, youth workers are out there on the front line working with young people, probably in a closer capacity than any other professional within the youth sector. You know, young people go to school, but the teachers just haven't got that relationship like how the youth worker has a relationship. You know, they go to sports clubs, they're out and about in the community, but the relationship a youth worker has with a young person is quite unique, and a young person oftentimes is more comfortable to share things, specifically around things they do that the parents don't know about, things they do with their friends, and you know, things just come to the surface, and I believe a youth worker would know very quickly if a young person is using, misusing, abusing substances. But yet, they wouldn't necessarily, well, I say they wouldn't, evidence has pointed to that they don't follow that up and make a referral to get them the support they might need. And I was stumped. I was like, why? What's the hindrance? What's the barrier? Why the hesitation? And that's the question I'm posting. I'm putting it out there. What's the issue? Why is it youth workers don't make referrals to other services, to other agencies? Is it because you know they're scared of ruining the relationship they have with young people? But then I would say, if they care that much about the young person, why wouldn't they get the support they need? Why wouldn't they signpost them to additional support? Is it because they don't want to generate any additional work for themselves? So, you know, they'd look at the referral form and think, oh, I've got enough to do, I'm not filling that out. Or is it because they don't want to formalise the issue, as it were? So, you know, they can have a discussion about it around a PS2 or, you know, whatever activity they might be doing. They're happy to discuss it there, but to then take it to the next level, it might just formalise it a bit more and, oh, now we're looking at paperwork, now I'm assessing you. Is it they're fearful of doing that? Or is it the accountability? Is it that they're scared of, not scared, I don't think scared's the right word, but is it they don't want to be accountable to what would happen next, or what, you know, what would come from making that referral? I don't know, but I'd love to hear your views, you know, so post a comment. I want to hear back from you guys. Why are youth workers so hesitant or resistant to make a referral to another agency? That's the question. So let me hear what you've got to say. I haven't got the answers. You guys are out there. You've got the answers. So again, just post a comment below and let me know. It's Tony Brown, Youth Work Toolbox. I'd love to hear from you. And don't forget the big announcement. Support me. I need your support. And just share this with someone. Yeah, just share it. Post it on Twitter. Stick it on your Facebook page. I'll speak to you again soon. Take care. Bye.